we're on our own, living life on these hard streets. We're locked and lost in mind. Is there any way to find? Are we running out of time out here? Listen. Hey, who's worrying about you, babe, when you wildin' now, running around in these streets?
We welcome you. Opening stanza of this 12-round fight. Teddy, let's key in on the obvious here, but in doing so, let's talk about his mentality as to how he delivers it. This is a guy that, for most part, wins all his fights by knockout.
Same mentality I had when I went to school. I couldn't wait till it was over.
Scores with the uppercut. He has his target. He lands a straight right. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Scored well with that right hand to the body.
Come on, baby.
Just a thudding shot there that he landed. Teddy, in terms of a power punch, we know the taller fighter is going to try to utilize the jab, but in terms of a power punch, what can he get that shorter fighter with?
The uppercut. Boy, oh boy, that can be like putting a cherry on top of an ice cream sundae. Because you know the shorter guy's leaning, he's coming in, he doesn't see that punch till it's too late.
Stay focused on the inside.
Comes with the right.
Hey.
Sullivan's defense did a good job there, able to avoid that punch. Good scoring shot. It was a straight right. Right hand over the top. Very accurate with it. Will you look at this? Look at this pace that these two are fighting at so early in the fight. Teddy, each man must have been determined to think they can get the other one out of here early.
Yeah, I want to see who blinks first, though. That's what's interesting to me. Who changes? They can't both keep this up.
A well-placed overhand right. Sullivan's movements really helping him out, avoiding that punch. Sullivan's effort in that last round really didn't do much for him. I just don't think he was busy enough.
No, he wasn't busy enough, and you start to wonder whether or not he wants to be here. It has to change quickly now, because if it doesn't, his opponent is going to kind of smell it a little bit, and he's going to start pushing a little bit more and put him in bad problems.
Scored well upstairs with the right hand.
Get close to him. Close the distance. You need to keep that head.
targeting upstairs. Effective work with that flush overhand right. Sullivan's tag. There's a good right hand. Sullivan's showing that he's got some defense of his own. He got away from that punch. Halfway through this round here. Solid left hand. Right to the head with that right. Nice block by Sullivan. Really on the mark with that over-the-top shot with the right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. He scores with the jab there.
You know, Joe, a lot of times you think about a jab being used by an outside guy, but to get inside, you need a cover. And there, right there, was the cover.
Come on, get focused.
That right hand serving him well. There's the headshot, but he parries it away. You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. Good block there by Sullivan. We come to the end of the round. Joe and Teddy with you ringside. Teddy, the punch stats prove it, but obviously, listen, if you're going to work more than the other guy, you're going to win the round.
Yes, you are. Usually, as long as those punches have eyes, as long as they're getting into scoring areas, clean shots.
Solid straight right hand. And now he's targeting upstairs. There's a right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Oh, and there he lands the right hand well. Protecting his head well with his guard. And banging away. Big, big shot comes crashing home. He just fought the other guy's fight. And now it's not his fight at all. He is down.
No, he should have been on the inside. He pulled out into a world of trouble. A world of punches.
There's a straight right hand. And now he's targeting upstairs. 10 seconds to go in this third round. Able to show you his blocking ability. Well played, straight right hand. And round three comes to an end. Well, let's look at Teddy's scorecard through three rounds.
Yeah, baby, good work.
And there he is scoring with the right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Showing you some defense there with the block.
Get inside, get inside. Good job.
That right hand serving well. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. And a right hand lands flush. And now he's targeting upstairs. There's that right hand he scores with. Sullivan's doing exactly what you should to be a strong defensive fighter. You got to block those punches away. Well, earlier you saw what happened to him. He was stunned. He got tagged in this fight. He got hit hard. Now you're seeing the kind of mentality that's going to try to avoid that happening again. But, Teddy, it's not necessarily the kind of mentality that's going to win you a fight.
No, if you're in the corner with him, you know what you tell him, Joe? You tell him, look, you're being tested now. I understand you've been hurt. I understand you're looking to survive right now. But you're being tested for the first time in your life. Do you want to be a champion? Do you want to be special? Special people find a way to get out of this and still offensively go forward.
Yeah, he's got to answer those questions.
Good job, buddy.
Sullivan's movement helped out there. He avoided that punch. Scores well to the head with the right hand. Sullivan's left now getting into the mix. Gets him with the right hand. He is damaged badly there. He may hit the floor. Sullivan's corner has got to get that message to him. He cannot afford to have defensive lapses like we just saw in that last round.
Yeah, you know, we say this so many times in a broadcast. We blame it on the fighter, but what if he hasn't been taught those things? If those things haven't been instilled already in the gym, guess what, Joe? He's not doing them.
That worked out really well. Throwing off the right hand after getting tagged like that. Took a shot. Now he gives a left. Little head knocking with that right hand. Frustrating his opponent with great defense. Sullivan's not jabbing that much right now. That's got to help out his opponent.
Yeah, you know, that's like giving him a free one. Because now his opponent doesn't have to worry as much when he walks in. No jab to keep him out.
Wow! And he goes down again. Will he get up from this?
One, two, three, four, five.
Over. The fight is over. Sullivan's unable to beat the count. Knockout loss for him. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Tedder. Round one of 12. He's a knockout puncher. Pure and simple. That's what he's done throughout his career. Win the majority of his fights by getting rid of his opponents.
Reminds me of us when we were in school. You know, you just couldn't wait for that last bell to ring. And how quick were you out of there? Bang, you shot out of there. That's how quick he gets to his guy.
See, he's got his guard up really well that time, and it protects his head.
Teddy, in terms of breaking a man's will, in terms of testing him where he doesn't want to be tested, what can the power puncher do against this fighter who the rap on him is he has low stamina?
Just keep the steady pressure on him. Make him start to think that you're an immovable object, that he can't do a damn thing about what's about to happen to him.
Able to place the right hand in there. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Halfway through round number one. Good return fire that time. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Able to land with the right. Nice block that time. It was intended to the head. Thomas is out there just waiting on a counterpunch, isn't he?
Yeah, well, first of all, why is he? Because he knows if he walks in, he's going to get caught. So what he wants to do is he knows there's basically a guard at that door. He's trying to get that guard to get out of there so he could go through that door.
Thomas is able to avoid that punch. Goes up top with a right hand. What a big shot. Late goings here of this round, and he goes down. Can he survive it? Thomas's wish came true. He was hoping for the end of that round. Now he has it. That was the only thing stopping him from going down.
Yeah, but it's not over. You know, you have to think like a fighter thinks. Yeah, for that moment, he got a reprieve. But he's got to go back in 1 minute and face it again. Does he have the wherewithal to do that?
Comes right back at him with a left hand. Thomas is trying to survive this. He is taking a beating right now. That one good shot came in and rocked him.
And that's the problem with his defense right now. You know, he's trying to block.
He is. And bang, and away he goes. Oh, and he goes down again. The question is, can he rise up and continue on? Thomas is up from the knockdown, but what we really want to look for is how he reacts in the coming moments of this fight. Good, solid right hand he lands there. Solid uppercut. He takes a shot and then commits to giving one right back. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Thomas is rocked and his defense is porous right now. He could go down at any moment.
Well, the problem is he's got the habit of blocking punches. When a guy's putting them together, you can't block them all. Some are getting through.
He gets hit, but he gives it right back. And now he's targeting upstairs. Clean shot with the right.
Keep it going.
Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. Thomas is hoping to recover right here. The way to do it, he feels, to tie up.
Yeah, it's not about machoism right now. It's about getting past his point, surviving, and then having a chance later on to get back to win the fight.
Oh, he's hurt right there. He is hurt. Solid. How is this going to go on? Once again, he hits the deck.
Well, he's getting practice at it, so he might figure it out.
And that's it. It's over. Fight is over. Thomas is smashed, and he can't get up.
In a world that's consumed by greed and wealth, it's a dog eat dog, and we cannibals for capital. The will to survive in the animal is natural, but the desire to rule in the pursuit of pure power is the path of the fool. We chase crowns till we land face down. Our worldly possessions keep weighing us down. In rain clouds, I move like a quiet storm. No shroud, stand proud, why should I conform? Beyond the norm, I exceed the hype. Beyond all the in the stereotypes. So this in your stereo, this is my life. On a day so dark, you would swear it was night. Night came with the beat to help me carry the light. So you can stand your ground, whatever the fight. You work for yours like I work for mine. On some P-Rod, got a purpose. What's next from the west, like I'm first in line. From the coast that's known where the surf and shine. Right rhymes like
like I'm trying to save the earth in time before my girls get big and give birth to mine. I encourage you to live, put the worst behind. Never worry about the past, it ain't worth your time.
Let me put it in this flow. We got all the goods we need, but got no money to grow. Hood got all the things, but got no.
Hi, everybody. So glad you're here. 36 minutes still ahead of them here, round one of 12. As we size him up, we can say this. He's consistent. Most of his fights have ended the same way. He wins by knockout. Iron Mike now facing. Big shot. The right came clean.
Keep moving. Get out there.
Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Committing to the work downstairs with the left.
Stand up.
Tyson's way off the. Oh, he is stunned. He could go down. Good block. Teddy, I think he's going to go down. I think he's going to go down after getting tagged right there.
He doesn't know where to go. I mean, he's like.
There it is! And crashing to the canvas after that uppercut.
One, two.
So now the question becomes, after that knockdown, and he has gotten up, how does he survive?
So this is where instincts kick in. You got to start moving that head automatically right now. You don't want to stay in the middle.
Able to lock in that target and bring it home well.
One or two more of those, it'll be the end of the night.
Oh, and there you go. And he crashes to the canvas once again. He's gotten up before. What about this time?
Three, four, five.
So now the question becomes, after that knockdown, and he has gotten up, how does he survive?
So one of the ways he survives is if he's been taught. Have good habits. Have good fundamentals been put there. You're going to find out right now. He needs them right
double
now.
Double up on your punches.
Very accurate with the overhand right. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. And now he scores well. Oh, a big shot comes home for him. How about that? He goes from being the victim to handing out the punishment. Tyson, 60 seconds to recover. Hopefully will be enough for him. Now he's got good cornermen. He's got the right people in place to try to fix this situation.
Yeah, and they got to work like a pit stop, you know, in the Indianapolis 500. One guy's giving the gas, another guy's changing the tires, you know, another guy's maybe giving the driver a little water. They got to do the same thing. Give him some water, refresh him a little bit, work his legs a little bit, and then just before he goes out, a little advice.
Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Nice combination. Throwing more than one. Both scored there. Good right hand. Able to get away from that headshot with the block. Comes with the right. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. And coming upon the halfway mark of this three-minute round. Blocks that punch. That right hand over the top lands flush. Mike Tyson's going with the mentality that, hey, yeah, I went down, I got hurt, but I can do the same thing back to you.
But he's forgotten that if he started this fight, it wouldn't be this way. He'd use his jab to set up punches. He'd be smart. That would give him the chance to land the big one. He has to remember that.
He returned fire right there, and it worked after being rocked Now he gets his man.
At this point, it's not about the skills and the abilities of these two fighters. It's about the dreams of them. And one of them is being eliminated.
That's an impactful right hand by Mike Tyson. Final 10 seconds of round number two. What a revealing round we just saw. Each man was able to hurt the other. You really can tell how much is on the line here between these two.
Yeah, they both came here. I mean, they're in the best shapes of their career. They came here understanding what this fight means.
That's a big uppercut that just crashed home. Huge uppercut by Tyson. Big shot. Well, we've seen Mike Tyson in a spot like this before. Remember, he once rose up off the canvas against Buster Douglas, only to be floored again. Can he do it here?
Keep moving.
There's a good right hand. And Tyson with a block punch. That right hand serving him well. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Good job staying away from the danger there. Well, you can tell he's being patient, waiting for a countering opportunity. Teddy, what does he have to think about laying that trap?
Well, all he has to do is think a little bit like I do at tax season with my accountant. I don't want to go into that office. You know, my accountant's standing at the door. He's waiting for me to come in there. I want a rebate. And that's what he wants. He wants a rebate. He wants a counter. He's stepping back, and he's waiting for the guy to come to him. So he's the one who gets his way.
Last 10 seconds of round number three. There's a right hand. And that's the end of round three. Wow, what a fight we've had so far. Just a chance to catch our breath as we start round number four. They've traded knockdowns. Now you have them up 2-1, Teddy. What's your thinking there?
My thinking is that the corners, they have indigestion. You know, they're looking for a little Maalox or something to settle their stomachs. But the audience, they're having a good time because they know it can happen again.
Comes right back with a shot of his own. And now he's targeting upstairs. Tyson's coming out here after being knocked down in the last round. Teddy, what are some of the things you look for that will tell you he's on steady ground, that he looks fine?
Well, the first thing I look for is the base, the foundation. I mean, you look at a house, you want to see, and you want to make sure that basement is solid, there's cinder blocks there. You know, you don't want to see that upper floor waving a little when there's a wind.
That's a big right hand.
Doing fine, you're okay. Move your head.
Teddy, explain this to me. Hey, this fighter, look at that. Knocked down again. Unreal.
Now you gotta wonder what the corner's thinking. Are they gonna stop this?
4, 5, 6.
There's just no quitting this guy. He's been damaged, but still he's trying to make a fight of it.
Look, I love that about him. The fans love that about him. It's great. But he's gotta learn when it's time to turn it off, when it's time to clinch a little bit, survive a little.
And now he's acting like a fighter, coming back with the right hand after getting scored upon.
One.
Some serious damage done on that power shot to the head.
Dropped his hand, paid a price.
Good effective work with that straight right hand. End of the round there, a round in which we did see the knockdown. And Teddy, when a fighter comes back to the corner, having just been floored,
Typically, Howard.
He is damaged badly there. He may hit the floor.
Let's go.
Body shot, left hand. Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him, he can counter him.
Left and right, left and right.
Up top with the right hand. Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Still plenty of time to work here in round number five. Minute and a half to go. Flush right hand to the body. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head.
Pace yourself.
Mike Tyson stunned. Wow, both guys have gotten to the other here. Blocks away that headshot. The end to another very entertaining round in what has been a very entertaining fight. A fight where there's just bad intention. The fight that just doesn't have the feel of a fight that's going to be a decision win for somebody. Looks like somebody's going to get stopped.
Right from the beginning, they've been fighting with desperation. Like, going the decision, as you just touched on, has not been in their minds at all.
He scored well after being hit himself. And now he's targeting upstairs. Blocks the headshot. Tyson's defense has been just unbelievable tonight. I mean, Teddy, you take such appreciation seeing a guy putting forth his craft like this.
Yeah, you do, and that's why he's able to have such a long career. That's why he's able to be, you know, so consistently good, because he doesn't take a lot.
He is not in good shape. He could be on the deck in moments. Solid. Well, he's been there before, and now he's there again. He got floored.
He can't afford to keep going on that floor. You have to wonder when the referee's going to step in now and stop this.
Six. Seven. Come on, get to your feet.
So he is able to get up to his feet after that knockdown. But, Teddy, it's what's ahead that's the problem.
Yeah, we're getting a peek right now into his heart, into his soul.
Flush right hand to the head. This fight could
two,
be over.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Mike Tyson rises up after going down here today. Final 10 seconds of the sixth round. Very nice work to the head. The right hand landed. He just missed that shot up top. And round six comes to an end. You can have the best game plan in the world, but when your eye shuts closed like that, everything changes.
But one thing doesn't change, Joe, and that's the mentality of a warrior. You find a way. You do not give in. You find a way. You concentrate harder, and you see with that one eye what you need to see.
Relax, relax.
Mm. Mike Tyson's tying up more now after being knocked down.
And that's what you expect. Punch. He's trying to buy Punch. A little time. He's not worried about winning this round right now. He just wants to get himself right so he can win other rounds. And he can be around for other rounds.
Hits him in the mug with the right. Not able to land the headshot. At the halfway point of round seven. Commits to the straight right. Just holds on there. Tyson's got a way of just getting away from that punch. Accurate shot. Straight right hand comes in. 10 seconds to go in the seventh. A little head hunting with the right. Start of round eight, Teddy's scorecard. A slight lead here, but I'll say this. He may be up on your scorecards, but his opponent knows how to land a punch against him.
Yeah, he's found a home for that right hand. He notices that he brings that left hand back slow, so the right hand beat him to the mark.
He took a shot, but he came back with a right hand of his own. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Comes with the straight right hand. Oh, he is stunned. He could go down. Mike Tyson's mounting a comeback here, Teddy. Things were going against him. Now the tide has turned.
Good things come to those who wait or those who persevere. He persevered, good things are happening.
Move your head. Keep it up.
He has his target. He lands the straight right. And now he's targeting upstairs. Big, big shot he just scored with. Roll the scorecards out. Mike Tyson's down and looks to be out.
One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
He reaches the count of 10. That's it. Knockout.
Never saw the punch coming.
Let's get the official particulars and send it up to our ring announcer. Well, he wanted to hear those words and...
Let it burn higher. I never show signs of fatigue or turn tired, cause I'm the definition of tragedy turned triumph. It's David and Goliath. I made it to the eye of the storm, feeling torn like they fed me to the lions. Before my time start to wind down like the Mayans, I show them how I got to grind down like a science. It sounds like a riot on hush. It's so quiet, the only thing I hear is my heart. I'm inspired by the challenge that I find myself standing eye to eye with. To move like a wise warrior and not a coward. You can't escape the history the truth is meant to make. That's why the highest victory is what I'm meant to take. You came to celebrate, I came to celebrate. I hate losing, I refuse to make the same mistakes. My heart, I'm inspired by the challenge that I find myself standing eye to eye with. To move like a wise warrior and not a coward. You can't escape the history that you was meant to make. That's why the highest victory is what I'm meant to take. You came to celebrate, I came to celebrate. I hate losing, I refuse to make the same mistakes.
ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, everybody. So
good evening.
So we are underway here. Round one scheduled for 12. As we size him up, we can say this. He's consistent. Most of his fights have ended the same way. He wins by knockout.
Teddy, what role can the fans play on the fighters, the atmosphere of the arena, when they know there's two guys meeting up that can bang?
An immature fighter, a less experienced fighter, can get caught up. He can try to satisfy the audience. That's a quick way to be going into the shower earlier than you wanted to.
And now he scores well with a straight right. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Morrison's cut is not looking good at all. I'm getting the sense that this fight could be stopped at any moment.
So the key is where the cut is. When the referee brings the doctor up to look at it, he's going to look at whether or not getting worse will imperil his health down the road.
Good block.
Come on, kid.
Comes with the right. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. Able to bring the hook down low.
Protect yourself!
Good effective work with that straight right hand. Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Final 10 seconds. There's a good right hand. And that does it for this round. Now that he's back in the corner, we get a close-up look. Morrison's cut even looks worse.
And it's up to the fighter now, Joe, for his attitude not to change. You know, we can look at it and we can say, wow, that cut looks worse. The fans can look at it and say that. But the fighter must be steady.
There it is! A good knifing punch. That back power hand just scored the knockdown.
Two, three, four, five.
Well, that may have been just a flash knockdown there, Teddy.
Yeah, I think he's okay. He looks clear-headed. His legs are okay. Now it's just a matter of making sure that he understands why he got caught.
Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. That right hand serving him well. Morrison's giving his opponent headaches here now. He's throwing punches, but he's able to block them away. That's a big right hand. Oh, and there you go. And he crashes to the canvas once again. He's gotten up before. What about this time? Tommy Morrison's corner needs to really get to their man after this round. They need to treat him after that knockdown. They also need to give him some sound advice. What's the advice you give him?
Well, first of all, if they're going to get the chance to get to him, he better move his head. But the advice I would give him is, hey, you go out this next round and you kill some time. Tie him up a little bit right from the beginning. Don't worry about losing.
Oh, a big shot comes home for him. Knocked down again. Unreal.
Now you got to wonder what the corner's thinking. Are they going to stop this?
He has shown some guts in getting up yet again, but now he may need a little bit of luck to survive.
Well, he's going to need a little bit of a clinch. He might need crazy glue to just get in close and make sure that he locks onto his opponent.
Targeting that belt line with the right hand. Brings a big power punch. It landed well.
Well, we were talking about getting into the kitchen. He went in there, and he tore apart that kitchen.
Tommy Morrison is coming out here after being knocked down in the last round. Teddy, what are some of the things you look for that will tell you he's on steady ground, that he looks fine?
Well, the first thing I look for is the base, the foundation. I mean, you look at a house, you want to see, and you want to make sure that that basement is solid. There's cinder blocks there. You know, you don't want to see that upper floor waving a little when there's a wind. You're looking at his legs. You want to make sure that they're steady, they're firm.
Good right hand. Morrison's hit to the head. Big shot. Well, he's been there before, and now he's there again. He got floored.
He can't afford to keep going on that floor. You have to wonder when the referee's going to step in now.
And it's all over. Tommy Morrison's unable to get up and continue on. Well, he wanted...